What is up, ladies and gentlemen? This is Dirk Hamel-Wood, and in this video I will be going over Chapter 16, Section 10, Social Impacts of Robots and Robotics. Positive social impacts, there are many. Robots can have many beneficial and varied effects in society. They can be used to complete hazardous jobs, which would not otherwise be safe for humans, such as bomb disposal. Another example are exploration robots, who help gather scientific knowledge as well as locating and recovering ship and aircraft wreckages lost in the ocean. In recent years, this is really important because almost 70% of the seafloor today remains undiscovered, and exploration robots can help do this because it reduces the risk to humans and the cost of actually sending someone down in a submarine. In recent years, three robotic rovers have even landed on the surface of Mars, sending back images and samples from the red planet back to Earth. Unmanned spacecraft have also been becoming more prevalent, especially in a situation in which it would be impractical to send a manned crew, or during routine missions such as resupply. One of the things that they've been doing is sending supplies up to the International Space Station, because if they sent up a crewed spaceship to resupply, then they would also have to bring supplies for the crew that is taking the resupply, which really is not efficient. So sending up an unmanned spacecraft is really a huge advantage in that regard. This is just a kind of a depiction of what one of the Mars rovers looks like. Obviously, as you can see, there are solar panels and, I don't know, moves on wheels, take samples and photos and all that jazz. And this is an example of what one of the underwater exploration robots would look like. They've got like the claw arms on the front to like take samples and move objects and whatnot. And yeah, there's that. Continued. Another role is fulfilled through the use of carrier robots, which manage large loads for the military and industrial scenarios. A specific example of a military one is the BEAR, or the Battlefield Extraction Assist Robot, which is designed to rescue soldiers on the battlefield. Now, I have a few pictures in the next slide, which I'll show you. Also, in class, one of the posters on the wall has a picture of the BEAR on it, which is, I think, pretty cool. Search and rescue robots. I've also been designed to search environments after natural disasters, such as ruined buildings, in order to pull out injured victims. I understand that these have been probably undergoing a lot more development since the 9/11 attacks, because something like 600 volunteers and firefighters and policemen all died trying to get people out of the wreckage. This is what the BEAR looks like. The first view is not really all that good at showing like the whole hind end, so I don't know, I included two pictures. It's pretty disturbing looking, if you really ask me. And these are examples of what search and rescue robots look like. The first one is designed to be like small, and it can go into little spaces and climb down pipes and fit into tiny nooks and crannies, so there's that. It looks for survivors like buried underneath rubble and whatnot. And then there's the other bigger one, which can probably traverse more obstacles and is more effective at moving quickly in order to find human survivors. Continued, again, domestic robots are designed to assist around the house, such as providing assistance with menial tasks, as well as announcing medication times or calling an emergency number if movement hasn't been detected for a preset amount of time. Obviously, you can see that this would be very useful for elderly people, invalids, and people that really have trouble taking care of themselves. Robots are excellent at performing identical actions over and over, making them ideal for manufacturing jobs, such as those along production lines or in factories. Now, in this next slide, I have two pictures. One is the standard for domestic assistance robots in today's society, and on the right is a picture of Sunny from iRobot, which, as you know, we watched in class, but this is kind of like what some people expect the future to look like for domestic robots, even though it really didn't turn out well in the movie. Negative social impacts. However, the use of robots in manufacturing jobs also has a negative impact as well. Because robots are infinitely more efficient than workers, as they don't make mistakes, have sick days, get tired, go on vacation, have coffee breaks, they put people out of jobs, obviously. Since one robot can replace several human jobs, the conversion to robot workers, whilst creating maintenance jobs, because people have to maintain the robots and monitor them and whatnot, it still loses workers. Finally, there is a higher potential for injury in a workplace inhabited by both humans and robots. Since they have trouble sensing approaching workers, there have been cases in which workers are severely injured or killed by active machinery, even with closely marked safe zones and all that jazz, so I'm not really sure how that happens. These are my references, and thank you guys for watching. So there's that.